to Betty's Kitchen. Today is another special day in Betty's Kitchen because we're announcing the winner of the second I Can't Believe It's Not Butter video contest. That began last Friday and it ended on Thursday at noon Eastern Time in the U.S. And the name of the winner is Pepsi 42327. Congratulations to Pepsi 42327. And for the rest of you who made comments, thank you very much for your comments. I appreciate them. They are helpful, and also I know you went to some time and effort to do them, and I really do appreciate them. I can't get back to everybody. Please understand there are just too many for me to respond individually, so I want to say a big thank you to all of you. Now, our new contest is beginning, so this is contest number 3. I will be making a recipe using I Can't Believe It's Not Butter, and if you make a comment on this video, then you will automatically be entered in our third contest. So good luck, and I hope you enjoy the recipe. Oh, and if any of you have questions about the prize, it's the same one. It's the I Can't Believe It's Not Butter VIP kit, and we have a travel drive. It's a, I think, 65.2 megabyte drive that has some information on it about I Can't Believe It's Not Butter, some recipes and tips and so on. There will be a butter spreader, which is by Crate and Barrel. It's very nice. And down here it was a coupon worth a product of I Can't Believe It's Not Butter up to $2.99, and that coupon is valid only in the U.S. You can still win the contest worldwide, but you can't redeem your coupon anywhere other than the U.S. And there is a Reach Right magazine that gives you a lot of information. If you want to know more about I Can't Believe It's Not Butter, you can visit their website. So good luck on contest number 3. It will end next Thursday, noon. That would be March the 25th at noon Eastern Time in the U.S. Today we're making Tex-Mex Snack Mix. And this is our I Can't Believe It's Not Butter contest recipe. So of course we're going to be using I Can't Believe It's Not Butter. And I'm using it in stick form this time. If you're just using a tablespoon, sometimes just dipping down into a tub of the spreadable form is nice. But I'm going to need a quarter of a cup, and that would be half a stick, just like margarine or butter. So that's what I'm going to be using in a few minutes. But in the meantime, I'm going to put all this snack mix together. And what I have is a box here of wheat Chex. I need only 1 1/2 cups out of that box. If you can't find wheat Chex, then you can use the corn Chex or the rice Chex. And if you can't find those, just some bite-sized cereal that you like, preferably not the flake variety. And then we're going to add some peanuts. And these are roasted peanuts, and they are salted. We need 1 1/2 cups of roasted salted peanuts. You can see the size of these. They're just kind of an average size of peanut. And I'm putting this in a mixing bowl that is large enough for me to put a few items and mix them around. The next item being sunflower kernels. And those are just sunflower seeds. The seed has been hulled so that the shell is gone and you have the meat of the nut. So we have 1 cup of those that we're adding into our mixture. This is going to be nice and nutritious. Now, it won't be low fat because obviously nuts and some of these other things have fat in them, but this will have a lot of energy and a lot of power in it. The next thing will be corn nuts, and this is just a snack type of thing made from corn. And if you can't find these, just find another snack in the snack section of a grocery store that you like, that you would like to put in here. Now, I will say you don't have to have all 4. If there's something you don't like, just leave it out. This is a mix that is not precise, so whatever you think you might like mixed together, put in this bowl, and then what we're going to do is season it up with some nice spices. You notice I call it Tex-Mex Snack Mix? That means it's going to be a little spicy, so let's start spicing it up. down here, I've measured out some spices. First thing I'm going to add is chili powder. And I have 2 teaspoons that I've measured into this container, which is a tablespoon large, but only 2 teaspoons are needed. And then I'm getting some red pepper. Right here it is. It's 1/4 teaspoon. So 1/4 teaspoon of the ground red pepper. Next I have cumin, nice spice to put in there, or herb. We need 1/4 teaspoon of that. And the last one of these is garlic powder. And it's an equal amount. Now, if you can just keep remembering that 1/4, 1/4, 1/4, all except the chili powder, that's what you're going to do. And in this case, we have 1/4 teaspoon of the garlic powder. I'm going to stir this together so that those herbs and spices can combine with our snack mix. But of course, this will not be good enough for the flavor to hang on to those ingredients. So this is where our I can't believe it's not butter comes in. I have taken a stick of this and divided it in half. That would give me 4 tablespoons or 1/4 cup. And I have put it on the stove in a pot, and here it is, melted. It just looks like melted butter or melted margarine. So we're taking this over and we're just spreading that around, pouring it over, trying to touch all parts of this, but we'll be stirring it in, so don't worry about that too much. Get that all blended in there, and we're going to just move those spices around, and also that I can't believe it's not butter should be dispersed so that it covers all of our snacks in there. And then the next step will be to put it in a baking pan like this one right here. We have a 15 by 10 inch baking sheet or cookie sheet. When you get this mixed up, then just start pouring it into your pan. Once it gets in the pan, what you need to do is spread it out. Just spread it out so there won't be one big lump in the middle or anywhere. Trying to get as much as I can out of there. That's about it, I think. So we'll spread. And when it's spread to the point where I feel like it is good, then I will put it in an oven, which is preheated to 300 degrees. And what I'm going to do is put it in the oven for 10 minutes, and then I will stir it really well. So I'll be checking on it then. And if it were done, I would take it out. But I'm expecting it may take another 8 to 10 minutes. So I'll be watching it every couple of minutes to see if it needs to come out. So it's very important that you don't let it get too hot or too brown, because it will take on a bitter flavor and it will actually be burned. So hopefully this will come out just perfectly, and I'll show you a nice Tex-Mex snack mix. Now this is what your Tex-Mex snack mix looks like when you get it out of the oven. I let it bake for 10 minutes and then I turned it all and stirred it up, and then I gave it 4 minutes more at 300 degrees all the way through, and I felt like it was done. So I got it out. Now it needs to cool. Once it cools, then you can put it in a nice serving plate, or you can put it in a sealed container and keep it for quite some time. Enjoy!